Oak Park High School is the third high school in the metro to stop a sports after a positive coronavirus test. District says a member of the football team tested positive for the virus. Those in close contact with the player are now under quarantine following district protocol. Four other people tested positive. Oak Park's playoff game against North KC tonight is now canceled. Rockhurst and Lee Summit North also forfeited their seasons after a positive test were discovered. Well, the City of Independence will continue its free saliva-based COVID-19 testing today. The city is using CARES Act funding to support regional testing efforts with 1,000 tests available each week. All today's time slots are filled. You can register for next week's testing online at the website you see on your screen. Well, the tests are estimated to take approximately 10 to 20 minutes. Results are available in 24 to 48 hours. By the way, here's a look at the 7-day rolling average of new cases on both sides of the state line. Kansas set a new record with 928 new confirmed cases. Health officials say the spike's due in part to a new automated monitoring system. Missouri's average is also up compared to a week ago. And a nursing home in Norton, Kansas will soon be removed from the Medicare program after every resident tested positive for coronavirus. The Anby Home will lose Medicare funding effective November 18th. A new report from the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services showed a lack of masks at the facility, and it faces nearly $15,000 in fines. Well, this year's Halloween will be unlike any other. From PVC pipes to individually wrapped bags of candy, people all across the country are trying to find ways to trick-or-treat safely in a pandemic. KBCN's Matt Evans is live this morning with what local doctors are saying about the risks of the holiday. Matt, good morning to you.
Rob, good morning to you as well. So, you know, a lot of the neighborhood streets, they are just simply not going to be as busy this year as they would in years past. They'll probably be the same here in the Brookside area, just like all over the country. So exactly what is Halloween going to look like? According to the CDC, some of the riskiest activities you can take part in include that traditional door-to-door trick-or-treating where there is physical contact with handing out candy, and also indoor parties where masks are not required and there's not a whole lot of distance between people. But doctors here in Kansas City say that there are still ways that you can celebrate Halloween safely tomorrow night. The first thing, no matter how you choose to celebrate, doctors say mask wearing is crucial, even if you're just in a small group, even outside. Doctors at KU Hospital say trick-or-treating can be done relatively safely as long as proper precautions are taken. One idea would be to slide the candy down a PVC pipe to trick-or-treaters at a safe distance. Another could be having individually wrapped goodie bags placed on a table more than 6 feet away.
Well, just trying to make it as safe as you can. You know, nothing's ever without risk, and certainly if you're somebody who has some illness, your kids have some underlying disease, and you may think it's probably best not to do any trick-or-treating, but I think you can try to keep it pretty safe. And we know that that's an important tradition, and even during the midst of a pandemic, sometimes you got to have a little bit of fun out there.
Doctors are warning against any kind of large parties or large gatherings, and they say with the current community spread of COVID-19 in the Kansas City area, the likelihood of someone at one of those large gatherings having COVID-19 has become pretty high. Live in Kansas City this morning, Matt Evans, KBC 9 News.